Hello, grade 7, and welcome to session 3 of our lesson, which is locating a point. Today, we are going to learn how to find the orthogonal projection of a given point in an orthonormal system. Before we start, let's remember what we already took. We already said that if a point belongs to the x-axis or the axis of abscissa, then the ordinate y of this point is 0. Then its coordinates is, it has a number here, and the ordinate is 0. Examples, k, negative 5, 0, and l, 4, 0. These two points belong to the x-axis. Their ordinates are 0. And vice versa, if a point belongs to the y-axis or the axis of ordinates, then the abscissa x of this point is 0. Then its coordinates could be written as 0 and any number here. Examples are 0, negative 3.5, and S, 0, 7. Look at these two points. They have 0 abscissas. These two points are located on the y-axis. Okay, so now we are ready to start. Let's learn how to locate and find the coordinates of the orthogonal projection of a point on both of the axes. It means on the x-axis and on the y-axis. Before we start, what is the orthogonal projection? Orthogonal means perpendicular. Okay? So, example 1. Find the coordinates of M and N, the orthogonal projections of A, which is 5, 8. Its coordinates are 5, 8. On x-axis and y-axis respectively. So, I want to find the orthogonal projection of A on x-axis and the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis. So, let's learn how to find the orthogonal projection, starting with the first method. Graphically, on the graph, so, this is point A. This is point A. It's located in the orthonormal system. How to find the orthogonal projection of A on x-axis and on y-axis? To find the orthogonal projection of A on x-axis, we make a vertical line which is perpendicular to the x-axis, a dotted line. So, the orthogonal projection of A on x-axis is M. The coordinates of M is 5, 0. Now, let's make orthogonal projection of A on y-axis. In other words, what is the mirror of A on y-axis? Okay, so we make a horizontal perpendicular dotted line to y-axis. Here it's N. N is the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis. What are the coordinates of N? It's on the y-axis, so its abscissa is 0 and its ordinate is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What do you notice? Look here. Here are the coordinates of A. Here is the orthogonal projection of A on x-axis. Here is the orthogonal of A on the y-axis. What can you conclude? We can say that the orthogonal projection of A on the x-axis, it has the same abscissa as A while the ordinate is 0, while the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis, it has an abscissa 0 and the same ordinate as A. So, now to find the orthogonal projection using the second method. M is the orthogonal projection of A on x-axis, and we said that any point located on the x-axis, its ordinates is 0, so M has ordinate 0, while the abscissa of M is the same as the abscissa of A, so M has a coordinate which are 5 and has an abscissa which is 0. So the coordinates of M are 5, 0. Now let's find the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis. N is the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis. So N is located on y-axis. And every point which is located on the y-axis has an abscissa which is equal to 0. And the ordinate of N is equal to the ordinate of A, which is 8. So the x of n is 0 and y n is equal to 8. Then the coordinates of n are 0, 8. 0, 8. So let's wrap up. We are finding the orthogonal projection of point A, which is 5, 8 on x-axis and on y-axis. The orthogonal projection of A on x-axis, so we delete the ordinate. Its coordinate will be 5, 0. 5, 0. The orthogonal projection of A on y-axis, so we delete the abscissa. So the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis is 0, and we keep the same ordinate, which is 8. So N is the orthogonal projection of A on y-axis. Its coordinate is 0, 8. Let's make another example. Find the coordinates of E and F, the orthogonal projection of S on x-axis and y-axis respectively. So, in other words, I want to find the coordinates of E, the orthogonal projection of S on x-axis, and the coordinates of F, the orthogonal projection of S on y-axis. So, using the first method, which is graphically from the graph, let's look at S. Here it's S. To find the orthogonal projection of S on x-axis, we make a perpendicular vertical dotted line to x-axis. Here it's E. E is on the x-axis, so its coordinates is 3, 0. To find the orthogonal projection of S on y-axis, we make a horizontal perpendicular line to y-axis. Here it's F, the orthogonal projection of S on y-axis. What is the coordinates of F? Since it's located on the y-axis, its abscissa is 0 and its ordinate, as you can see here, it's -7. So the coordinates of F is 0, negative 7. And as you can notice again, E has the same abscissa as S. Its ordinate is 0. F has the same ordinate of S, and its abscissa is 0. Let's find the orthogonal projection of S on x-axis and y-axis using the second method without the graph. E is the orthogonal projection of S on x-axis. Look, on x-axis. So we just delete the ordinate. It will have the same abscissa as S. So E has same abscissa as S, and its ordinate is 0. So the coordinates of E are 3, 0. We write E, 3, 0. Now let's find the coordinates of F, the orthogonal projection of S on y-axis. Pay attention, on y-axis. So we delete the abscissa. So the coordinates of F are, its abscissa is 0, while its ordinate is negative 7. It's the same as the ordinate of S. So the coordinates of F are 0, negative 7. 0, negative 7. Okay? So here are the coordinates of N, which is the orthogonal projection of S on y-axis. And we are done. By this, we finished our session. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.